Hello everyone, it's your girl Skylar here today, and you may wonder why I'm in a cage. It's not, it's a wonderful chair. Just moved to a new place. Pretty cool. My roommate's pretty chill. We have to hang out more, but anyway, so long story short, I have my surgery coming up very soon, and I made the mistake of YouTubing SRS videos of the actual surgical procedure. And I was like, eh. So I played the first 10 seconds, and after a couple gags, was like, you know what, I should do a reactionary video on this. So thank you all for tuning in. I will be posting the link to the original video in the description. They have a wonderful, wonderful video full of very happy and relaxing music while they literally destroy a penis. I mean, not destroy it, turn it into something more beautiful, but at the same time, I'm terrified. So, without further ado, we're gonna get this thing started, and I will, you'll be able to see my face actually as one since I turn the light on. Make it a little bit brighter in here, right? I guess not. Okay. So yeah, now we're here, and we're going to just start the video, because I tried to find another place to play it, but it's the best we got. So you can see my face react and horrify. God, I'm just looking at the cover photo. Okay, so if you click this link, click it at your own risk. It's terrifying. I'm telling you that right now. It's terrifying. You're welcome. Okay. Here it is. All right, so we're gonna start the video in 3, 2, 1.
Hit the subscribe button or visit us at auau.auanet.org.
Perfect fucking music.
Gender confirmation has three main challenges: maximal vaginal length, prevention of neovaginal prolapse, and optimal cosmetic appearance. The objective of this video is to show our technique for vaginoplasty using a scrotal graft and a modified dissection that prevents neovaginal prolapse, avoiding sacrospinal fixation. The surgery begins with marking the scrotal skin for the neovaginal graft, as well as the perineal flap, which will become the posterior introitus.
That's gonna be me. Oh, god damn.
A graft is then prepared on the backbench. The dermis is meticulously cleared of both adipose tissue and hair follicles. Once ready, this graft is then tubularized on a vaginal dilator.
Advertising Play-Doh.
Testicles are reflected laterally prior to degloving the penis.
That's right, guys. They're going to deglove.
Markings are made for the neoclitoris. Once the penis is degloved, it is inverted, leaving a superior skin cup. Bilateral orchiectomies are performed, taking care to preserve the adipose tissue around the spermatic cord, as this tissue is used for the labioplasty. A Lousley retractor is used to mobilize the urethra and the prostate.
It's like something out of Alien.
Denanvier's fascia is opened, and the space for the neovagina is created.
Fuck.
Dissection continues superiorly, up to the level of the pouch of Douglas, and laterally to the ischial spines. The bulbospongiosus muscles around the bulbar urethra are carefully excised. This maneuver will reduce bulging in the introitus.
Oh! He's hungry for spaghetti and meatballs. Fucking ugh.
A plane is then created on the degloved penis, preserving this dorsal neurovascular pedicle for the neoclitoris.
This is masochism fun.
Corporal bodies are dissected off the urethra. Using the ligature device, the cavernosal bodies are excised. The dorsal glands is then used to create the neoclitoris. Within the penile skin, a window is made to create the vestibulum. The labiaplasty begins with connection of the inferior aspect of the penile skin to the created perineal flap. The neovaginal graft is then sutured to the remaining penile skin cup.
It's like a hot dog. What the fuck? The last time I watched one of these,
further
I was like 12.
Cosmetic modifications to the labia are then made.
And it was like 2 in the morning. I'm so fucking glad I'm doing this, my god. I'm so fucking glad.
The distal urethra is spatulated and used to create the floor of the vestibulum. Around a Foley catheter. A window for the neoclitoris is created. The operative time was 360 minutes. Estimated blood loss was 200 milliliters. Vaginal packing was removed on post-op day 5, and the patient was discharged on post-op day 6. Final vaginal length was 13 centimeters. Out of our 46 cases in the last 2 years, only one patient who was morbidly obese experienced a degree of neovaginal prolapse. The combination of perineal flap and scrotal graft allowed the patient who was morbidly obese experienced a degree of neovaginal prolapse. The combination of perineal flap and scrotal graft allows for significant lengthening of the neovaginal cavity. The extended dissection of the rectoprostatic space up to the level of the pouch of Douglas allows for omission of sacrospinal fixation, thus reducing the risk of damage to the pudendal neurovascular bundle. This modified vaginoplasty technique has excellent cosmetic and functional outcomes with optimal vaginal length and minimal complications.
To the people out there that say, you know, oh, being trans isn't real, it's all like a scam or something, why the fuck am I smiling? And yeah, terrified, but actually happy after seeing that. I don't know. Holy shit. I'm so fucking, I don't, God, I'd like it, these past couple days have been pretty crazy. Cause I've been like, you know, was booked to school and shit, and then all of a sudden I had a bunch of time to think about this and to figure out, you know, where I was going with some of this, and it's been emotional. Like, it really has been. Because I have like a year's worth of pent up stuff that I wasn't really able to show while I was, you know, hammering my brain with, because it is a very difficult major. But holy shit. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed, and will come and visit my channel again, or my page, or whatever. I will post the actual thing in the description, and again, 6 days till I go and get mine, unless it's positive for COVID, but I already had COVID, so I don't think I will. And yeah, that will be, you know, I'll be recuperating all summer. I'm working on getting a voice coach over the summer so I can just focus on transition, because honestly, that is goals right now. That is main goals. I've been kicking my ass this year, and I feel like I've just put so much of this on hold, and I was not happy. I'm trying to focus on this, you know, not beating my brain in a fucking major that, you know, is difficult, and yeah. So anyway, again, thanks for watching, and I will see y'all in another video. Peace out.